I'm Dr. Danny Dusek. Being a Melbourne local and animal lover, I'm always on the lookout for places that feel the same about our hirsute friends. So I brought Bear to Pets Indulgence for a bit of a pamper. Come on, Bear.
Places like this are also great if you need a bit of pet-free pamper time. Drop them off, head to the shops or your own human groomer, and you can pick up your beautiful, fragrant friend once you're both ready.
As any pet owner knows, your animals can start to take over your home. Very quickly, you find yourself buying furniture that'll take the scratches and hide the fur, cushions just for your canine or feline mate. Most importantly, plants that aren't toxic to them. Kaz, you must get a lot of people come in for help.
Every day we get people in, and they might have new dogs or new cats and they're a little bit nervous, but there's a large range of plants that are pretty toxic to animals, so it's a good question to ask.
Absolutely.
And there's plenty of ones that are totally fine. So your big ones that are totally toxic are any variety of peace lily and devil's ivy, but there are some fabulous plants that are totally fine, so any of your fern varieties. I'm a huge fan of ferns.
They are beautiful.
We've got some peperomia varieties which have amazing leaves. So really beautiful plants that are totally fine. I get people dragged in by their dogs, and
really?
I think it's a lot to do with the energy in here, but it's a really dog-friendly area, so it's always a joy to have them in store.
Now, in case it's starting to sound like a bit of a girly weekend, let's not forget that men have dogs too. Believe it or not, they even go to the shops like brick and mortar. Oh, Will would love that.
I think it's great for the dog. They can get out and about, wander around the streets. I think the owner, I think it's great. Go to the barber, bring the dog, come in here, get a t-shirt, get some pants. I love having the Paw on the Door campaign down here. I think for the area, I think it's amazing.
It really is surprising how much open space there is around here with all of the parks and the recently opened Paran Square.
No, they're not. It's a question I get asked all the time.
How many dogs are you walking a day?
We walk up to about 50 a day, which is, so it's very surprising because we're in a city, but lots of people still have dogs. Lots of people in apartments, so that's where we come in. So we come in and take them out so they can get out during the day while everyone's at work.
What are you doing when you're off duty?
So I'm still walking my own dogs. It's great in this area because you can take them everywhere. With all the shops on Chapel Street, they've got the Paw on the Door, so you know you can take your dog in there.
As you can see, the Paw on the Door campaign has been a massive success for Chapel Street, not to mention the dogs and their humans. I really hope this takes off everywhere.